Hey guys, my name is Olya Huntley and welcome to Rush into Russian. Today I'm welcoming you from my kitchen, and no, I'm not gonna give any cooking master classes today, but I am going to speak about the Russian Pancake Week. It actually starts today, March 8th, 2021 in Russia. But every year it is different. It is actually sometime from the end of February to the beginning of March. And this is the celebration of spring. And yes, Russian people still do celebrate it. But it is actually an old holiday. It has pagan roots. I'm going to give you 5 fun facts today about it. Also, I'm going to show you a short video from a few years back, before the pandemic at all, when we celebrated this holiday in Tampa, Florida, but with the Russian community. There's gonna be a lot of fun facts in this video, so maybe grab a tea, make a pancake, who knows, and let's get into it. So let's start with the roots. Yes, as I said, it has a pagan roots. Some information says that the name Butter Week, Masla, Maslenitsa, butter, a week, actually started from the 17th century. 17th century is when it was officially added to the church holidays in Russia. But you ask, what's that information for me, right? What do Russians actually do during this holiday? Well, the modern Russians actually don't really celebrate it as in depth as it, I think, used to be celebrated, but we do eat a lot of pancakes. And if you go to restaurants, they'll have special menus organized, and at home people make it. And I mean, if you're not into pancakes, probably not really, but generally, at least once during this week, you're gonna have a pancake or two. So let's talk about these pancakes. What are they? Well, they're not really looking like American pancakes. They're more like French crepes, and they're thin, and oh my gosh, what can't you put on the crepe, on the Russian blin? This is what it's called. You can put sour cream, you can put just butter, you can put jams, you can put meat, mashed potatoes, you can put salmon, you can put caviar the Russian way. So pretty much everything and anything. But why? Why make these things? Why? So Maslenitsa is the first celebration of the spring, right? The celebration of welcoming spring. Pancake or crepe or blin, it's round and it's yellow. It looks like sun. So this is why it's welcoming sun. It's welcoming this warmth and bright energy. And also every day of this week is special. Right now, people don't really follow it. Maybe only on Sundays, but not really. But before, every day used to have a special meaning. For example, on Mondays, you welcome the holiday. You welcome Maslenitsa. You make this little effigy or chuchula, and this is a little interesting, but you're gonna actually burn it at the end of the week. And yes, we still do burn it at the end of the week. I'll tell you a little later why. And Tuesday is usually a play day, so you go out, you take sledge rides, you have fun. Wednesday is a sweet day, so you can put all your jams you want and eat all the sweets you want. Thursday is for physical activities. Friday is when you went and visited your relatives, and especially your mother-in-law. You don't want to forget her. And Saturday is when the young wives hosted the parties. And Sunday was the big festivities, celebrations, dancing, putting some traditional costumes, and burning the chuchula. And yes, people still do that. You can still go to the big central parks of pretty much any big city and have the celebration. There's a lot of food, there's a lot of dancing, singing, and at the end, they will be burning the chuchula. The cool thing about the last day of the week is also that it is a day of forgiveness. So you ask for forgiveness, people give forgiveness. It's a nice little tradition that came from before, and some people still do that. Some people don't. It's called Прощённое воскресенье. But mostly the last day is still about partying, dancing bears, eating a lot of food. Oh, wait, you said dancing bears? Yes. So the bear does have to do something with it. There's no bears walking around the streets in Russia right now, but the bear has some connection to this holiday. So long time ago, it's believed that it has a different name. It was called Камаедица, Which is not really, I don't think a lot of people know about this now, but it is connected to bears waking up for the spring and actually people bringing the pancakes or crepes or blini to the bears because they were like the kings of the forest. So that's one opinion of what happened, but we do have some people dressing up and dancing in bear costumes, but I think it's just more for fun and the laughing of it right now. So here you have it. I hope you learned something new about this interesting holiday. And now I'm going to show you a little celebration that we did a few years ago here in Tampa, Florida. We got together some Russian people. We got people from the university, the Russian club at the university, and the professors actually organized all of the activities. And we had a lot of fun. So if you want to see what people do, different types of things, different Russian foods, and a little bit of traditional kids Russian stories in this case, you can continue watching this video and you'll see it.
Давайте, давайте, давайте.
Привет, я Крис.
Я Вадим.
Я Даша.
Я Оля.
Я Конор.
И мы едем на Масленицу!
Nothing in my world is wrong. At least I'm not the only one. Nobody wants to live alone.
Russian, how fast? Go ahead.
Ты русские буквы там знаешь, американец?
Скоро, go, go, go.
Today today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And if you did, please press like, subscribe to this channel, and you can watch a lot more videos. Just click on one of those on the left of your screen, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.